Hi guys, it's Crystal with Design Bundles. Today I want to talk about designs. What size are we supposed to size our designs for our t-shirts? So that's a common question that we get here all of the time is, how do we know what to size our designs? So I'm going to go over all of that today. So let's go ahead and get started. Let's start with the basics. Let's find our real estate. The best way to do this is to take two rulers, and right here on the sides where your sleeves are, you're going to see right here. You want to get your rulers right on the side. So get one here and one on the other side. This in between is where we have to play with, because what's on the other side of that ruler is what's going to be on the side of the body. So you don't want your design on the side of the body. So you want to stay in the front. So right here, I'm going to measure and we're going to get 11 inches. In the industry, an adult t-shirt is around 11 inches by 11 inches. You don't want to go over 11 and a quarter by 14 high. So now I'm measuring that height and I'm going to look at the 14 and say, this looks good. So I want to stay within that 11 and a quarter by 14 inches. So as you can see here, I can see my real estate. This looks good. So I know whatever I size it, if I want it to be as big as it can, I want to stay within that field. So let's go ahead and start off with playing Goldilocks. So I'm going to pop in a design here. This one is printed on an 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper. And it came in around 10.5 inches when I measured it wide. The next one here is on an 11 by 17 sheet of paper and it's 13 inches wide. So I think the one on the right is too small and the one on the left is way too big. So let's find that medium. So as you can see here, I'm gonna measure and show you guys. So this one came in around 10 inches and the other one came in 13 inches. So that 13 inches, as you can see, is gonna go over. That's gonna fall on the side of the body and we don't want that. So let's go back to the drawing board. Let's find the middle of that a little bit. So here's this design here, and this one is around 11 inches. So doesn't this look better? It looks better than the way too big design. It looks better than the way too small design, and that's staying within that field. So you can see that there, and it's about 11 and a quarter to be exact. So I think this looks great. Now what most people don't explain is, what about a vertical design? Now this one is more of a horizontal design. What if it's vertical? Do we stretch this design out? For example, here's the one on the right. This is an 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper. And if I bring back in my ruler, this is gonna give us an 8-inch design. So I think this is just too small. So we're gonna have an 8-inch by around 10 inches tall. So I mean, you may look at this and say, okay, I think this looks okay, but I definitely don't think it's perfect. Now the one on the left, this is printed once again on 11 by 17 sheet of paper, but I think this looks way too big. This is gonna give us like 12 and a quarter. I think that if we did around 11 inches high for this design, it would be perfect. But I wanted to let you guys visually see these things so you could really say, okay, I get this. So sometimes we're visual learners and I really hope this helps you guys. Now, what if it's a circle design? You're going to be the same way. This design right here is printed once again on 11 by 17 sheet of paper. And so I stretched it out as far as I could and I've got, you know, pretty close to around 10 inches wide. I probably could stretch that a little bit further to reach all the way on that 11 inch to get it absolutely perfect. Now let's talk about HTV, heat transfer vinyl. It's gonna work in the exact same way. So I have blown this up as big as you're supposed to take it. So this is 11 by 11. So this is gonna fill up that real estate. I'm not falling on the side of the t-shirt. I've brought it down 3 inches, 3 fingers, and it looks perfect. I think, you know, maybe it could come down just a little bit. We could do 3 to 3.5. And I'm gonna bring back in those rulers just to show you that we are staying well within our area. We've got plenty of room to work with. And this looks great. You can even size this down just a little bit if you wanted to. Now, what about a design like this? Something smaller. What if I brought that all the way up to the top, the 3 fingers down? That would be way too high. Same thing, if I went off the top part of that D, it's still way too high. This is one of the situations I really wanted to point out. Not everything is equal. So you need to visually look at this. Before you put the heat to it, you can play around with this as much as you want to. If you need to, put the t-shirt on. Put the t-shirt on whoever it's gonna fit closest to you so you can see it. Put it on a mannequin. So that way you can see where does it fall on the front of a t-shirt. I always recommend go walk around stores, look at their t-shirts, see how they're designed, and always, not always, do even designers get it correct. So you can look at a t-shirt sometimes and say, that looks a little bit too high. So the point of this one is, you know, this one's not even 11 inches wide. I believe this design right here was 9 inches wide, and you want to bring it in a little bit smaller. I could have even brought this in a little bit smaller if I wanted to. So with a design like this, it's more about playing around with it, figuring out what works best. So here I bring in that ruler, and it is. It's 9 inches wide. So not all designs need to be blown all the way up. This is something that you're going to get the feel of when you do it over and over and over again. So just know you don't want to go bigger than 11 inches by 14. You really want to stay within that 11 by 11 when it comes to an adult t-shirt. Now, once again, when you have a bigger shirt, you know, you're going to get in the 1X, 2Xs and all that. You want to look at the real estate, play around with it, figure out what works best. Another thing that I can recommend is get yourself a good black and white printer and print that design out the same size you would if you were using sublimation or HTV, and that way you can do what I did here today and you're not wasting those products and you can visually see and figure out which one works best for you. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope you found it helpful. If you did, please hit the like button down below and subscribe, and I'll see you guys on the next one.